Ooh, they've gone.
Yeah.
They transformed into an extraordinary miniature landscape of hills. It's fantastic, isn't it?
Mm,
are you
it's
pleased?
It's kind of like a miniature of Wai Valley around here.
Of the Wai Valley?
My hometown's Tama Valley too.
Ah, OK, yeah, which is very steeply sided, mm-hmm. isn't it? I like the little Val d'Oie wandering path that disappears
well done,
over the top.
Nigel. Well done,
over
Nigel.
The pass into the next verdant valley.
But it's not all Zen gardens and straw mats. The rest of the ground floor is given over to open plan, Western living. This is all very generously organised and so different from the dank place it was, thanks to the glazing. And a significant part of this building is glass. Windows reflect the forest. They bring the forest in. It's a connection that only grows in intensity the higher up you go. The stylish first floor looks right out onto a wall of variegated green. The top floor is up in the canopy, and the privacy this brings has allowed them to build a little world of Japanese indulgence.
Oh, this looks entrancing.
This is our attempt at a Japanese bathhouse.
Two hot rails, two stools and two little bowls and showers.
Matching showers.
This is where you prepare yourself for the bath. Is that right? You shower first to clean yourself.
We do.
I think it's such a civilised idea. If you're going to share a bath with somebody, get clean first.
In Japan, it is traditional to bathe naked in the company of others. In Britain, not so much.
So I'm being modest. Hope that's all right.
No, for the sake of modesty, we're all wearing bathing costumes.
So sit on here and then do your showering. Yeah, everything is just there.
Do you not find it easier to do this standing up, Nigel? Or have you been...
No, it's just...
...inducted? I'd want it up here to stand underneath, no?
And then you've done your hair. Oh, fill this up.
Watching a grown man shower on a miniature stool is all part of the surreal Japanese experience this house has to offer, almost as surreal as sitting up in the canopy in a wood-fired Japanese bath. To rebuild their old home into this, to provide such a surreal experience, has cost Nigel and Tamayo £200,000, £25,000 more than they expected.
We're skint, absolutely skint now.
But you are rich beyond measure in other ways.
Mm. Beans on toast now, every day.
Yeah. Beans on toast.
But we started to think, OK, let's go. We've got the money just about, we think, to create the vision that the architects gave us. Let's go with that and see how far we get.
This sounds like a brilliantly wrought justification for making it up as you go along.
Well, we don't know any other way. So... No. I don't know if I'd recommend it because it comes with its own stresses and points along the road where you think, what have we done? Have we, you know, we haven't thought this through. Yeah.
Is there a little surprise that the building's thrown at you, which you enjoy?
Actually, the biggest surprise, I think, was the rooftop. The view from there across the trees is something we never dreamt of.
The biggest thing I like is something I couldn't get in this country before, having a hot tub and having Japanese space in this country and feel closer to my family and friends in Japan.
Bringing Japan to Wales is, of course, a supremely romantic gesture. For that, Nigel and Tamayo should be applauded. I have to say, I truly thought they would experience more trouble on the way, that the result would be more compromised.
So, how is it, I hear you ask, how is it possible that a couple with no experience, not very much money, and nothing much in the way of drawings, get to finish such a beautiful, elegantly detailed building? Well, I think the answer partly lies in inheriting a pre-existing building with a slab and some walls. It partly lies in choosing the cassette build method, which allows you to work from the outside in and keep the building watertight. It lies in selecting a range of windows that are pretty standard, and for that matter, in finishing the inside of the building in a straightforward, simple way. Oh, and then there's gambate, which is the Japanese word for can-do attitude. So was this the vicarage?
It was indeed.
So I see the point of all this now. You're in the park.
Yeah. We're going to give it a whole new identity.
The planners come along and decide they don't really like it.
That's what it boils down to. You've ordered the bloody things.
Persistence beats resistance.
The glass is 60.
60? You could build a house for that. I've never seen an old vicarage that looks like this.